Dear learners, once again, I'm happy to take you through the second lesson of social studies. Last time, we looked at location of places using lines of latitude and longitudes. To remind you a little bit, we say that latitudes are the imaginary lines drawn on a map from east to west. And we have the distance, which we refer to as latitude, meaning the distance of a place north or south of the equator. So today we are going to look at something else, that is the importance of latitudes. Latitudes are so important on maps such that they help to determine the climate of an area. Then second, latitudes also help to locate places on a map. So we have a method of locating places, but this method is by using lines of latitude and longitude. So this method is referred to as the grid reference. So we have a simple question: state the location of East Africa on the map of Africa. East Africa lies between latitude 5 degrees north and 11 degrees south of the equator. Then when you come to lines of longitude, East Africa lies in between 29 degrees east to 42 degrees east of the prime meridian. We are calling east, reason being East Africa is in the eastern hemisphere of the prime meridian. That's why we have 29 degrees east and 42 degrees east of the prime meridian. How do latitudes help to locate places? Latitudes help to determine how far a place is north or south of the equator. And how do latitudes help to determine the climate of an area? All along, we said that latitudes help to determine the climate of a place. How do they determine the climate? Areas near the equator are hotter than those far away from the equator. And again, latitudes help to determine the climate of a place in such a way that areas near the equator receive more rainfall than those far from the equator. Why are areas near the equator hotter than places far from the equator? This simply is that they receive direct sun rays. By the time these sun rays reach the ground, they are still very hot and can heat the ground faster than other areas that are far from the equator. So we look at some of the few countries that are crossed by the equator. Our motherland, that is Uganda, is very lucky that it is among the countries crossed by the equator. So it lies within the northern and the southern hemisphere. So we have these countries include Somalia, we have Kenya, we have Uganda, we have Democratic Republic of Congo, we have Congo Brazzaville, and Gabon. So these are the few countries that are lucky, and they lie along the equator, and they are within the northern and southern hemisphere. So we have even lakes. In East Africa, we have only two lakes, dear learners. That is Lake Victoria and Lake George. They are the only lakes in East Africa that are crossed by the equator. And we are lucky that all these two lakes are within our motherland, that is Uganda. So attached is an activity. Dear learners, you can attempt that activity and forward it for marking. Thank you so much. I remain Teacher Eugene.